Hi everyone, welcome back to our channel. Hope you guys are well. And today in this tutorial I am going to show you how you guys can make this amazing glowing profile card using just HTML and CSS. And here you can see that we have an image, and if we hover on this image, you guys can see that this is actually transforming to the top, and it is transforming in a circle image. And here we have name and profession and some text and some contact me button. So you guys can see that this hover effect is looking good, and you guys can make this effect in your website. So in a few minutes I will show you how you guys can make this effect using just HTML and CSS. And before we start, if you guys are new in my channel, then please subscribe my channel, like this video and press the bell icon for the future videos. So let's go to our project file. So here is our project file. You guys can see that these are the three images I am going to use, and here we have index.html file and CSS file. First we have to open this index.html file, and in this index.html file first we have to build a basic structure and give a title and link our CSS file to the HTML file. So here you can see that in our website I will put everything in one card. Here one image and name, profession and text and contact me. This everything will be in one card. Okay, so that's why we have to first create a div tag, and the class name will be card. That's it. And inside this card div tag I will create another div tag, and this div tag class name will be info, and I will put every information in this div tag. So that's why info. And here I have to create another div tag for our name, so that's why the class will be name. And underneath this div tag I have to create another div tag, and the class name will be profession, so prof, that's it. And underneath this profession div tag I am going to create another div tag, and the class name will be, here you can see that in our profile after the name we have our profession, and then we have a horizontal line, so that's why divider. Okay, divider, and that's it. And here in the name we will write a name, which is John Doe, that's it. And here will be designer. And underneath this div tag we have to create another div tag, and the class name will be bio. And here we have to type lorem and just tab, and we don't need this much, so that's why I will delete some line. That's it. And underneath this div tag we have to create a contact me button, so that's why we have to now create a button, and here write contact me. That's it. And underneath this info tag we have to create another div tag for our photo, so that's why the class name will be photo. That's it. And underneath this photo section we have to create an anchor tag for this one, this is my YouTube channel. So that's why there will be hash, and the name will be my YouTube channel. That's it. So if we now save and go to our website and here refresh, so here you can see that we have our name, our profession and our text and button and our YouTube channel link. Okay, so now we have to style these things, so that's why we go to our style sheet, and here we have to create our basic styling, and then we have to define a background color, so that's why background color will be this one. Now if we go save and refresh our website, so here you can see that we have our background color. And now we have to get this thing in one card, so that's why first we have to give a height and width of our card, and here you can see that we have a width and height of this card, so we have to do this here also. So that's why go to our HTML file, copy this card class and paste it here. And here first we have to give a height of 450 pixel, and then we have to give a width of 310 pixel. That's it. And now we have to give a background color, so that's why my background color will be white. So if we go now save and go our website and refresh, so here you can see that now we have our width and height and our background color. Now we have to give transform and give a scale. 0.7 so that it can take its width and height specifically. So that's why this transformation. And now we will give our border radius. So that's why border radius will be 8 pixel. And I'm going to give a box shadow. So here you can see that in our website we have a box shadow here. So I want this box shadow. So first it will be 0 and 0, and I want a blur of 80 pixel, and the color will be 1 pixel, and the color will be this one. If we now save, go our website and refresh. So here you can see that now we have a specific width and height, and we have our box shadow. So now we have to style these things. So that's why go to our style sheet. Now here you can see that our every information is now in this info class. So now in our website, these things in is now in a start. I want everything to be in center in one column. So that's why I will grab this info and I paste it here. And then first I will give a width and a height. So that's why width will be 100% and the height will be also 100%. And I want to display will be flex, and the flex direction will be column, and the justify content will be center. That's it. If we now save, go our website and refresh. So here you can see that now we have everything in the center. Here now we have to style our name and a profession and our text. So that's why I go to our text editor, and here in HTML now we have to grab our name class and paste it here. And now I will give a font size, and it will be 35 pixel, and font width will be 600, and font color will be this one, and position will be absolute, and I want to take some space from top. So that's why top it will be 100 pixel, and I want some space between the letters. So that's why letter spacing will be 2 pixel. That's it. Now save, go our website and refresh. So here you can see that now we have our name. Now we have to design our profession. So that's why go to our website and copy the profession class from here and paste it here. That's it. Now copy everything from here and paste it here. Now I want to change the font size. It will be 25 pixel, and I don't want the font width. So delete this line, and I want a color of this one, and it will be 140 pixel from the top, and I don't want this letter spacing. So delete this line and save, go to our website and refresh. So now we have our designer. So now after profession, now we have to create this horizontal line. So that's why go to our text editor, and here copy the divider class and paste it here. And I will give a background color with this one, and I will give a height of 1.5 pixel, and I will give a width 50 pixel, and position will be absolute, and I want from top it will be taking 190 pixel. That's it. If we now save, go our website and refresh, and here you can see that we have our horizontal line, but it is not its in correct position. So that's why go to our text editor here, and from the card, and here from the info, now we have to delete this flex direction. Now save and go our website and refresh. So yeah, that's it. Now we have to style this text. So that's why go our website and copy this bio class from here and paste it here. Now first thing, I will give a position of absolute, and the from top it will be taking 220 pixel, and I will give a font color. So that's why color will be this one, and I will give a line height of 28 pixel, and I will give a font size 18 pixel. Now save and go our website and refresh. Now here you can see that now there is our text, but I want to this text in center. So that's why now we have to define text align will be center. Now save, go our website and refresh. So here you can see that now everything in center. Now we have to style our contact me button. So that's why go to our text editor, and from here now we have to copy our button and paste it here. So this one will be position absolute, and from bottom it will be 30 pixel, and I will give a background color, so that's why background color will be this one. And I don't want any border, so that's why border will be none. And I will give a font size 20 pixel, and I want some padding from top and bottom. It will be taking 13 pixel, and from left and right it will be taking 25 pixel. And I want a clickable button, so that's why cursor will be pointer, and font color will be white. That's it. Now save, go our website and refresh. So here you can see that now we have our contact me button. So now we have to bring this image now, so that's why go to our text editor, and here now copy this photo class from here and paste it here. Now first I will give height of 100% and width of 100% also, and our background image will be URL, and inside this URL we have to put our image file name. So my first image file name is 1.jpg. That's it. And I don't want any repeat, so that's why background repeat will be no repeat, and position will be absolute, and I don't want any space from anywhere, so that's why bottom will be 0. And I will give a background size, and it will be 100% from top and bottom, and 100% from left and right. And I will give a border radius of 8 pixel. That's it. Now save and go to our website and refresh. So here you can see that now we have our background image. Now we have to create our hover effect on this background image. So for doing this, go to our text editor and copy this class from here and paste it here. And here you can see that in our website, when we hover on this card, you can see that when we hover on this card, then this image is transforming. So here we have to create hover on our card, so that's why go to our website and copy this card class from here and paste it here and write hover. That's it. So when we hover on this card, our photo will be transforming, so that's why card hover and photo. So now we have to create transform and scale. So from top and bottom it will be take 0.5, and from left and right it will be take 0.35, and I want translate y also, and here it will be taking -650 pixel. So now save, go our website and refresh. So here you can see that now here is our hover effect, but it is not looking smooth. So for doing this, we have to give transition in our photo class, so that's why transition will be 1 second. Save, go to website and refresh. So here you can see that now it is taking 1 second for transforming. Now I want this image to in round, so that's why we have to give border radius, and the border radius will be 50%. Now save, go to website and refresh. Now if we hover on this image, so you can see that this image is not looking in the center, so we have to bring this image in center so that we can see the face. Now we have to create background size 100% from top and bottom, and 150% from left and right so that we can see the face. And I want to have position, background position, so that's why it will be 0 from top and bottom, and from left and right it will be taking 25 pixel. Now save and go our website and refresh. So here you can see that now we can see the face, and it is looking in the center, exactly center. So that is what I am talking about. So yeah, and now we have to now style our button. So that's why go to our text editor, and from here copy this anchor tag, and that's it. And here now we have to give position absolute, and from bottom it will be taking -70 pixel, and I will give a font size of 25 pixel, and let's give a font color, so that's why color will be this one. And I want a background color, so that's why background will be white. And I want to give this width of 100%, and I want a padding, so padding will be 12 pixel from top and bottom, and 0 pixel from left and right. And let's give a font width, and it will be 600. Now let's go to our website and save and refresh. So here you can see that now we have our my YouTube channel button, but I want this thing in the center and I don't want this underline. So that's why text decoration will be none and text align will be center. Go to our website and save and refresh. And here you can see that we don't have any space between this card and my YouTube channel button. So that's why I will create some space. This will be not actually box shadow, this will be actually bottom. And I'm sorry about that, this will be the bottom. That's it, now save, go our website and refresh. So now here you can see that we have a space between our card and our button. And now we have to make other two ones. So that's why I go to our HTML file and here. Let's create a div tag and the class name will be box. And inside this box tag I will put everything, our three card and everything. So that's why this will be box and the ending point will be here. So now just that's it. Now copy this thing and paste it here for the second card and again paste it here for the third card. Okay, now save and go our website and refresh. So here you can see that now we have our three card, but I want this three card in one row, not in one column. So for doing this, go to our text editor and just copy the box class from here and go the top and here paste it. And we just have to type display flex and flex direction will be row because I want everything in one row, and justify content will be center and because I want everything in center. Align items will be center, that's it. And I want a width of 100% and also I will give a height of 100 VH. That's it, now save, go our website and refresh. So now here you can see that we have our three card in one row and it is looking good. Now we have to change this to image. So for doing this, first go to our text editor and here, and this one is for our first image and I don't want to change anything here. So that's why go to our second one and here in photo we have to type photo 2. Okay, this one is photo 1. For first one is actually for photo 1 and the second one will be photo 2 and the third one will be photo 3. Okay, change these classes. Now save and go to our HTML sheet and here find the photo class, this one. So copy everything related photo and paste one time for the second image and here the class will be photo 2. Let's change it and again paste it for the third photo. So this will be photo 3 and photo 3. Now change the photo. This one is actually for first image, but I want the number 3 of image. So that's why 3. And for the second one, I will change it to 2. That's it. Now save and go our website and refresh. So here you can see that now we have our three different image. So let's see our card is working or not. So here you can see that we have our image and the glowing shadow and it is looking so good. And if we hover on these images, so you guys can see that this is looking so cool. So yeah, I think everything is looking good. So here actually in contact me, I will give this font weight. So go to our button and here is our button and let's give a font width 600. Go our website and refresh. So here you can see that now we have our bot contact me and this is looking good. So yeah, that's it guys, our work is done. I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial and if you guys really enjoyed this tutorial then please subscribe my channel, like this video and press the bell icon for the future videos. And if you guys have any question about this video or any other video, you guys can comment below. And see you in our next tutorial.